start with the objective of the class today is to get familiar with the two things. One is a practical thing on developing ontology, and then the tool itself, the Protegi. So we'll be using Protegi, but there are other ontology editing tools that you can select depending on your preference. But I'm using Protegi here. So hopefully everybody has Protegi installed and running. I know some Mac people have some problems, but I don't know how to solve the problems on the Mac. So I think you can help if you guys need. We are not going to solve those problems today. Hopefully you can follow it later as exercise. The domain I selected for the application today is social networks. I wanted to select something that everybody can familiar with. So let's start with social. So social networks. So as you remember, the first thing you need to do is come up with a list of the things that comes into your mind when you think about the social networks. The second step is to list down few queries or the question that you would like to answer from your ontology, and then go on designing the ontology. So let's start with listing down few things that comes into your mind when you think about social network. Can be Facebook, Google, G+, or anything. So help me here. I have some list, but you can participate too. So I start with person. Okay. By person, I mean anybody who interacts in social networks. And we all have post, right? So, and photos, video, what else?
Message.
And then album, and then groups.
Friends.
Sorry?
Friends.
Friends. Any suggestions? Anything? Maybe location, because people tag that I'm here, right? Location, community. Anything else that comes to your mind as objects in the real world? That's all I have to. Okay, so let's start with these things. Now we have set of things that we would like to include in our social network ontology. And so what are the interactions, what are the relationships that we are interested in? So somebody can be a friend of somebody, right? So we have friend of relationship. So here are the entities, and here are the relationships that I'm trying to list out. So, and the next can be somebody can comment on something, right?
Share,
yeah. Like. And then there's this concept called follow. And then we can tag. Anything else that you can do on page, on social networks as activities, as some action?
Tweet. Post.
What?
Tweet.
Tweet.
A post.
Post as a, yeah,
so now
Sorry?
It's a noun and a verb.
Yeah.
Emotions.
Sorry?
Emotions.
Emotions. What do you mean by emotions? Expressing?
Yeah, I like my friend.
Feeling.
I like my
feeling.
Okay. Express? Does that cover anything else? Okay, so let's start with what we have. And let's try to come up with a good model to represent these things. Okay, now we have these things. What are the interesting questions that you would like to ask on the data set on social networks? So let me start with that. I would like to see who are the friends of X. Right? Who commented post Y? What else? So here I can have, so people say they can express their relationships in the network, right? So let's say spouse of something like that. So spouse, brothers, or I can say anything that comes to your mind. I think I had some list.
Okay. It would be like, who's in a group? What groups are people in?
Okay. So something like that, right? So we started with listing out all the entities that we are interested in and some of the relationships, that some of the activities that you can do on social networks, and list of questions that we would like to answer from our ontology, from our representation of the social networks. So let's get started with modeling these things. And as we move, we will figure out, okay, this may not be. So we'll start with modeling these things, and we can figure out the best ways to represent these things on the in Prodigy as an ontology. So this is my Prodigy. I think I'm using 402. So I'll start with creating a new ontology, and here you can see tags where you can say entities, classes, object properties. I'll be probably using this tab, class tab, object property tab, and then data property tab, and probably some DL queries. So this tab where you model all your entities on this site, you can say what are the relationships between them, basically the hierarchical relationships. And then we can use the object property tab to basically represent all these relationships. So relationships are two types, right? One, as we mentioned in the last class, we had attributes and the relationship. So here all the object property means if two entities in your domain interacts with using an activity here, that's object property. Data property means you have some entity, but the other side of that is the data property. So for example, I can have a person and say has name, and name is a string. So that's a data property. Right? Or I can represent that as a name, which it as a class. So name, which is a class, and it has first name, last name, right? So in that case, it's an object property. Otherwise, it's a data property. So here you can write Sparkle queries. That's this time, and then this is the DL query lab, this description logic queries lab, query tab, where you can write your OWL axioms to get the answer. So we will write few simple things here because we did not really learn about the OWL, but just to demonstrate the value of having ontology, I'll use some queries there. So let's get started. So our first object is person. So let me add it here. So here you can add classes. Person. And then I have post. And then if you think about these four things, photo, video, message, and album, all these things are post, right? So photo is a post, video is a post, these things are, you can categorize them as posts. So whenever you define the class, we should use, the convention is to use the singular noun. So post, and then all other four things we decided to have them as a subclass. So let's here this time we'll add subclasses for the highlighted class. So I have what? Photo, I have video, what's the difference between groups and communities? As per me, group is a concept from Facebook and community is a concept from G+, right? So, but basically they are same, I guess, right? So I would say group equivalent to, you can use here, and say that it's equivalent to community. Now, whoever member of community or group, member means instances, is a group too. If, so let's say in our group, right, we have Semantic Web, Cement Web 3.0 as a Google D plus community. So that will come under community and then it will automatically should be classified as a group too in our conceptual schema. So we did that. And then we have location. Let's add that as a class. And then we have friend. Okay, friend.
Yeah, I don't think a friend is as a type of thing. I think a friend is a relationship.
We have person here, right? Is every person is a friend?
Definitely not.
Not right. So let's say now we are interested in answering that question, right? Who are the friends of X? In that case, yeah, we can represent that as a relationship too. But if I have to add a friend as a class, I would add that as a subclass of person, I think. All friends are persons, right? Not the other way. So let's do that. Yeah, we can represent that as a relationship too. But I have something else in mind to demonstrate, so let's go with this. So basically I think we covered all the interested entities in our domain here. Hopefully yes. And then let's move to properties. So let's start with here we have a property friend of, and we would like to represent somebody is friend of somebody, right? So in that case it's an object property, it's not a data property. So I would add it here, object property. And then I have comment, share, like. Those are the things that you can do on a post, right? So instead of adding them as three different things, I would add this thing, respond to. And all these things are different kind of responses, right? So agree? If you have any different opinion? Because there's no one correct way to design any ontology.
I wouldn't say a follow is a response.
Yeah, so comment, share, and like.
Oh, those three, yeah.
Follow is
different.
Friend
or something.
Express. Person.
Okay, yeah.
Or something.
Tag can be kept on foot also.
Sorry?
Tag
is something you can do on
photo.
Okay. So
even share can be in the response. Share.
Yeah. So I'm thinking about having these three things plus this thing as respond to.
Follow also.
This one?
Yeah.
Follow is a for person.
You don't follow
really
somebody's status, though,
right?
We won't follow the status. We follow the person or like a group or something.
Yeah, I wouldn't categorize follow as response.
Follow is for page.
Yeah. So let's add these four things under response. So as we have hierarchy for the classes, we can have hierarchy for the relationships too. So let me add it here. Comment.
Yeah, that creates a new
one. Now the problem is comment is a noun, right? Normally.
So
but here we are making
it. Comment share.
Let's make it little explicit.
Comment on.
Comment on.
So
tough, making those things as verb is tough, because I cannot say liked. But normally the properties, we try to express them as verbs, so that it's not confusing.
So should it be likes plural?
Likes, okay.
change it?
No, you can't change it.
Yeah, you can. You can't change. I don't think you can rename it here.
That seems kind of silly.
And then what we have, express.
Tense, right? Present tense. You could. So you would. I would express your relationship. This person likes that thing.
Okay.
It's always a present thing.
Now we have all these things, and then we have these follow. Sorry, I forgot something too. So whenever we add this relationship, we should try to have domain range for the relationships. So respond to domain is, so somebody's response into respond into some post, right? So the domain of the respond to should be person.
I respond to people.
Person respond to post.
Post. So post is a range.
Yeah.
So person is the subject, so person is the domain. I'm sorry, I missed it.
Yeah, so yeah, subject is the domain.
Object is a range.
I don't know which one you clicked on. I thought we were going.
Oh, cool. Domain. Domain is person. And range in our case is post.
There you go.
Right. And then friend of. So if A is friend of B, B is friend of A too, right?
Maybe.
So let's model this it as that way. To say that, you should say that my friend of is symmetric.
Okay.
And domain and range is person, right? For friend.
Yep.
Range is person.
Now we have covered these things. Now we have follow, tag, post.
Excuse me, how did you open this window? Correct.
Which window?
Yes.
So this is, we are on object properties tab.
Yeah, I'm there, but when you went to domain, you show the person, then how can I get this?
So when you click on any relationship, this should be there.
Only, okay.
Now we have two other relationships. Follows. So follows, what's the domain? Somebody follows. You can follow post, you can follow person, you can follow group, everything, right? So the domain is person, that we know. And the range is basically you can follow any of these things. You can follow, except for location, right? So I would say range is the thing. Which is the topmost class.
Come again?
Sorry?
What did you say?
So we had the problem, what is the range? So we have four candidates for the range.
Yeah, and except the location, everything can be a range.
Yeah, so I would say the range is thin.
Okay, but location?
Yeah, but it will not tell you that location is in the range. So when you say the range, you can specify the superclass, but it will not tell you that everything under that is a range. It can be, not necessarily.
But sometimes even it is like, it can't predict it, right? Like if there is a location, how can system comes to know that the location is, I mean, it is not true, right? So someone can't follow the location.
Yeah.
So if you give the range as a thing,
uh-huh.
So there is
somebody
a chances even
that
to
a, okay.
a location, right? So.
That's a good question.
It depends on your definition of location, right?
Yeah.
If location is like a store or a bar or a school.
Okay, so let us specify that in a different way then. So except for location, everything is candidate for range. So I would say, so what I did was click on the range, okay, and here you have four tabs.
Mm-hmm.
I went because, so if it is one class, I can simply select it here. Okay. Now we have a group of class. So I go to class expression and say person or
group
host or
group or community.
Because we said group and community is equal, we don't need to say it. So yeah, then all in total,
that's
three, right?
And what's the difference between that and just adding the three things, the three
So now we are saying that range should be from these three classes.
Mm-hmm.
Previously we said range can be from thing, which includes location. So in this case, we don't have the location.
Right, but I guess my question is,
mm-hmm.
can I not add a second range value that was the other classes? So I could have, in my range, I could have three rows. One would be post,
I think
location.
When we do that, I think what you're saying is, just to let others know what I think he's suggesting is, have post and then add another one, person. And then group, right?
Yeah.
Am I correct? Okay. I think in this case, how Protege interpret this is range is person and post and group.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can explicitly say it is not that.
They're my classes.
Okay.
I'm sitting at some work.
So I added post with domain person and range post. Post as a relationship with the range post of the from the objects. And then we have, I think, let's say spouse of. It is symmetric, right? A is spouse of B and B is a spouse of A, right? Okay. Can you go again? Okay. So these are the basic things that we can think about, but let me add few more relationships here to express the to demonstrate some expressive things on the out, right? So somebody can say somebody follows something, and you can say it in the other way too. Followed by, right? And how do you connect these two things is to say follows inverse of followed by. Okay. And I think here we can say so when you say something like that, probably A equals B, A equals C, right?
Which one?
So we are talking about same person here, I guess.
Yeah.
So to express something like that, you can say spouse of the A is reflexive. And then it should have
dominant range. Okay, each person.
Yeah. In terms of reflexive spouse of yourself?
Yeah.
Is it reflexive?
Yeah, is it symmetric?
No,
or
that
reflexive?
Is functional, right? Let me. Oh, sorry, yeah, it's not reflexive, it should be functional, right? So.
I don't know what to do. Am I symmetric and asymmetric? Am I transitive?
Yeah, to express this property, you should say spouse of is functional, not reflexive. Sorry.
You can put friend of as
friend of as reflexive. Really?
You are friend of yourself. Mm-hmm.
Okay, just to make sure that everybody on the same page, we have these relationships, and okay, even I don't have domains and range, so followed by, okay, we have the follows, right? It has domain as person and range as person, post or group. And followed by should have, I think it should get it right. Should I specify the dominant range again for followed by when I say it's inverse of follows? Let's try this. So what I'm arguing myself is, so we have follows and followed by, and I specified dominant range for follows.
Yes.
Right? So I. It can impact, right? So I would not specify the dominant range for followed by because with the reverse, right? So let's see what it does. And then I have post, I have spouse of, I have respond to, I have friend of. Okay. So that's pretty much the schema. Which are the entities that we are interested in, the domain and their relationships. Okay, let us add some data properties too. I would say
so does data property just describe the type of
Sorry?
I'm distinguishing between object properties and data properties.
So the data property, so the object properties, we had our domain objects as domain and range.
Okay.
Right? In the data properties, one side of that is data. That is predefined data types that is defined in our language. So that can be string, date, integer, long, decimal, all these things.
Okay.
So I would say here, as name, name is a string.
How did you open this window? Did you double click it?
So I added hash name as a data property
yes.
and then click on range.
Your range, okay.
So then, is function property means equal to your functional property means only one value should have to the property. Like spouse is functional because there should be only one spouse.
No, I think that means when you say something is spouse of some one object, then however, like if you have multiple representation of that, this is one.
Okay.
We are talking about one entity here. Yeah, I would not add a lot of data properties. Just to show that how to do that, I just added one. Okay, so now let's add a few more. Now we have the schema, right? We said these are the objects we are interested in, entities we are interested in, and these are their relationship. But we did not add any concrete entities, right? So let's do that. For that, you can go to individual track here, and let's try to add a few entities.
Is it up? No. So look on this please.
Click on the group.
So I'll add two persons. Let's say so we are on the individual tab. If I click on a class and then add some objects, it should say this is type of that class, I guess, but it is not doing it. But I can do it manually. So basically I add individual and I want to say that it's a person. To do that, I said I click on that type and select person from the class hierarchy. And
I was going to make an EM early. Not that there is one.
Okay.
Just for example.
So now we have two individuals for person, and let me say John. So to establish the relationship between these two things, I'm trying to say that John is spouse of Anne. To do that, I'll click on that object property assertions, and then it will show your property hierarchy. where I select spouse of and say and.
Yeah, even though we said it was reflexive, we didn't. I don't see the opposite occurring.
Mm. Like if John and if you take John and Anne, right? So if you give Anne as suppose of John, and when we click on the John, it's not showing that it's suppose of Anne.
Oh, we didn't do that yet. So you need to do the reasoning of that.
No,
so
we
just
already gave that suppose as reflexive, right? So it should.
Yeah, it'll do that.
Okay.
We'll get there, I guess.
Yeah, we'll get there. So I added John. Spouse of Anne. Now he was asking, we said spouse of as symmetric, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now it should be the other way too. To get those inferences, go on to this reasoner menu where you can select multiple reasoners. I selected the Hermite reasoner not for any special reason. And I say start reasoner. Hopefully, yeah. Okay. Why this is friend of whatever?
Friend of your reflex.
But where did we say that if you
John is friend of John?
No, we didn't say that it is
sorry?
Friend of mentioned as reflexive as an
example. Oh, now John is friend of okay, sorry. Fine. so we added John spouse of Anne and say spouse of is symmetric, and if you go to Anne now it says spouse of John, right?
Mm-hmm. Right, and it's got a dashed line around it, which I'm assuming means it's reasoned, inferred.
Yes. Yeah, those are not added facts, those are reasoned. Now I will stop my reasoner. Okay, and it will disappear. So, to confirm how the functional thing works, I would add another person. And say
type.
Is anybody else missing the reasoner in their download?
Yeah.
Drop down?
Like start reasoner.
Everybody has the reasoner, right?
No.
No.
Oh, no?
Should download the plugins.
Oh, I'm sorry. Check for plugins. Check for download. Okay. Give it a minute. I'll give you a list. I picked back.
Just a minute so that he is on board.
We'll figure it out. His display isn't displaying text we can read.
Okay. So, I added Cameron and I want to add him as a person. And...
excuse me. Can we lock the... lock one of the multiple choice? For example, I'm going to select Anne or John as the spouse of Anne, okay? But I don't want... Alloy means lock it, so by mistake I don't give two spouse to John. So John can have only one spouse, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in case if I add it now, it's adding. So I can have multiple spouse to Anne. Is it possible I lock only one choice?
Yeah, you can say the cardinality on the spouse relationship, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you should be able to say that, but...
even without cardinality, it is functional, right? You can add
yeah, so that's the way to do that normally, but she
is... But it is, then your knowledge base is not very. You can add things, but it's not correct.
Yeah, it's
you
not correct.
Validate,
I know it's not correct.
Yeah, you have to validate the knowledge base before use.
Before use. Where?
So you think I can add another individual
based
and make
them there is any conflict, it's not correct. Consistent.
Yeah, so the way that I would do that is this way. So let's say now I had a John has spouse Anne, right? And I would say Cameron, spouse of
Anne.
Exactly. Right? So now there shouldn't be two spouses for the same girl, right? So we said spouse of as functional, right? Now if I do the reasoning on this, it will tell me John and Cameron are same individual. So you can see when I click on Cameron, same individual as John. And if I click on John, it will tell same individual as Cameron. So basically what it did was, it said that there shouldn't be two people for Anne with the relationship spouse of, and say these two should be the same guy you are talking about. Okay. So did everybody get that?
Yeah, mine doesn't do that.
So you did the reasoning and it did not come out?
I did the reasoning and it, even though I have two spouses of Bob Marley, it doesn't relate them.
Do you have spouse of as a functional relationship?
Mm-hmm.
How do you?
Strange. So if you go here, it should be functional first.
Okay, so a person is a thing. Person has a super property. See, apparently that's implied.
So
for Anne right now, it's not showing the spouse of two people?
It shows the spouse of Cameron and spouse of John.
Right.
And in the same time, it has John and Cameron are same individuals. So if you click on Cameron,
uh-huh,
it says same individuals as John.
Oh,
here.
I see.
Right?
Can you go back once for Anne?
For Anne, okay.
Yeah. Why does it come like friend of Anne again? Like,
because I think we said friend of as.
Okay.
That is my friend of.
Even though if it is reflexive.
Yeah, reflexive.
But it is not correct, right? Like, how can he be the friend of him?
Okay, then let's get rid of this reflexive.
So that's where you model, right? You are.
Yeah, you can do that or not.
Okay.
So if I take out this reflexive thing and say that if you say friend of is not reflexive, then now if you go to reasoner, now you don't have it.
Yeah.
So because we said it's a reflexive property,
okay,
it added that triple. So now I want to do some interesting thing here to say that I would not add any member to friends, but what I would do is I would say, let me add one more guy here, Mike, and I want to say Mike, who is a person. Friend of John. Now what I did was I added somebody called Mike as a person and say he is a friend of John. Right? So now we have friends in our database. Mike and John. Right? And I want to infer all these members as Mike and John as members of friend, right? I don't want to add them explicitly as friends here, but want to infer. So to do that, I would go here, friend, and I think you can say, let me try. content. So to do that, what I would do is, so I have a class called friend, and I have people in the data level say that John is a friend of Mike, and I want to say John and Mike are members of class friend, right? To do that, I would declare my friend class as equivalent to, so basically what I'm trying to say here is, so I have, and because we said this is asymmetric, you can basically say, right? And now our conclusion is John and Mike are members of class friend. To do that, you can declare your class friend. I want to get whoever appears on domain orange of friend of as members of friend, as members of the class friend. So to do that, I would say my friend class is equivalent to whoever who has a relationship friend of with another person, they are qualified for class friend. Right? So my friend class is equivalent to friend of a person. So now if I do my reasoning, it will populate members for the class friend, which includes Mike and John, because John and Cameron are same individuals. It basically listed Cameron here too. Otherwise, John and Cameron are is single person.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Can you say again, reasoner, then what you did? From the reasoner you went up, then what you did? Yes, then?
So, mine was like this.
Yeah.
And I just say start reasoner.
Yeah, mine is inactive. Why?
Do you have any these two options? Do you have reasoners?
Yes, I have all of them except the reasoner, start reasoner. All, I have all of them. Oh, should I click
select something that's not none?
Yeah. Right. It is select here. It should be
none
either hermit or.
Yes, it was none. None
okay.
Has gone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Select one of these reasoners
yeah,
and start.
Sorry.
Okay. So what's the next thing that whom I want to do? So let me show another inferencing task here. So I would add individuals for post. So I would add a photo. I don't know, I have to, every time I have to say 5. Shouldn't be the case. And I just add a photo. And then say that Mike. I want to say Mike.
There you go.
Commented on. Photo, okay, and then let's say and likes the photo. Okay, now we have two actions on this object, which is the profile pic. So somebody has posted the profile pic, and Mike commented on that, and Anne likes on that. Okay. So now we want to know who are the people who did who responded for a profile pic. It can be comment, share, like or anything. Okay. So we can do that because we said all our all likes, share and comment on as relationship respond to. Okay. So how do I do that? I can write a simple query here to say that give me all the people who respond to, isn't it a relationship? Respond to
profile.
Why do you say it? Okay, so I wanted to get whoever who responded to the profile pic. By respond, I meant comment, share, like, or anything. So we had two people, Mike, I think, who commented on the profile pic, and Anne liked on profile pic. So I just had one query to say that give me all the people who responded to the profile pic, and by using the reasoning, we could come up with the answers Anne and Mike. Otherwise, what you have to do is to say that give me all the people who commented on something, liked on something, and get the union of it, right? So, because of our representation as subclasses, subproperties of responded to, we could infer that thing. So, that's another thing. Okay, what else I can show? You can do the same thing for to get the friends, right? So if I have people who are friends with somebody, you can say friend of some whoever. Let's say, I don't know if I have data, it will come up. Okay, yeah. So you can do such queries. And you can do the same thing with Sparkle too. And this is a dear query. What other scenarios that I can
come?
Yeah, this is a simple thing we are using. We added group and community as a equal object, equal classes. So if I add individual to community, it should, let's say we have semantic web community. And then go back here and I do the reasoning.
So can we give a domain and range for even that?
Domain and range for?
The thing which we created now, for community.
Yeah, no, because community is a class, right?
Okay.
Domain and range exists for the relationships only.
Okay.
So community, so yeah, so the semantic web is now under group two, which is an inferred thing. And so how to do the restriction? So all these things are adding expressiveness, using expressiveness of the language itself to do some reasoning. And let's try to do some restriction. So we want to say that a group should have can have maximum one owner, right? So how can I say? Let's say the community. Can say, I guess, can go here, express that as a subclass of okay, I don't have a has owner. First I need to add the relationship called has owner. And say that its domain is community. And the range is person. And now I can go back to my classes and define community as a subclass of something which has owner, person, and I can say maximum one. You can select it here and say maximum one. So now I define community as maximum one person as owner. So let's try to break that rule in the instance level. So that's the schema level thing, right? Now I would add we had the semantic web community, and let's try to add owner for that as owner. Let me see whether my reasoning is okay. It stopped. I add has owner and okay, and everything should work fine. Everything works fine. Now I stop my reasoner and add another owner to the semantic web group. Now I have two owners for the community, but we said there shouldn't be. Let's see. Yeah, so it throws an error, but it is not detailed enough to say we have to figure out what is the reason, but typically you can get it when you do the programming. So it basically throws an error for the reasoning, concurrent modification. I don't know why it is doing that, but basically it was not able to interpret the actual error, I guess. Now if I get rid of one owner, then everything should be fine. Yeah. So it says has owner because John and Cameron are same guy, right?
Excuse me, can you say how did you say that community and group is equal? Same way. And the classes?
In the classes, you can say that when you define the class, you can say it.
Okay. Equal.
Yeah,
equal
okay. To
yeah.
Some
yeah.
Other class.
Yeah,
okay. I have owner max 1%.
Okay.
I don't have symmetric and inverse every day.
Okay.
Well, no, because it would be owned by.
Okay, I think that's the exercise that I wanted to cover. How to design the ontology and get familiar with the protege and have some idea about what kind of inferencing that you can do on using the OWL language. It's more special than this, but I did not really cover complex scenarios. You can basically write a lot of queries here, even I'm not familiar with the OWL really well. So you can write DL queries there and infer based on your schema to get the results. And as a note, we can do the same thing with Sparkle too. So the Sparkle has the inferencing component. In the query, you can say do the inferencing for the results. Yeah, I think that's it.
I
covered what I wanted to cover with you guys. A few well-known ontologies called FOF, a friend of a friend ontology, and good relations. V-card, visiting card, right? So those are ontologies that people develop inferencing in mind. Not I think good relations, but friend of a friend is something like that. It's been developed for like 12 years now and it's evolved well. So you can go and browse through their schema and it's very descriptive. And why they did that, those things are there. So you can go on that and learn yourself for the ontology design. Yeah, that's it for the class today.